Hello and welcome to this video about the best audio options for the Insta360 Ace Pro. I've already done a best audio options for the Insta360 X3 and you can see that in the cards here. So I'm going to compare all the audio options and give you real life examples of them in use. The first option is going to be using the internal microphones, and we've got many microphones on the Ace Pro. We've got one here, one on the top, one on the sides. And they're going to give a good coverage for internal microphones. So that's the first thing we're going to look at. Second thing we're going to look at is using AirPods as your audio source. The third thing we're going to look at is using a dedicated lav mic. So I've got a lav mic here. And to use the lav mic, you're going to need to have the Insta360 Ace Pro audio adapter. This is very similar to the one you get for the X3, but you can't use this in the X3 and you can't use the X3 one in this. And the last option we're going to look at is using a dedicated wireless microphone set. And this is the Movo wireless microphone set. And it contains two of these transmitters and run receiver. And this is currently my go-to wireless microphone set for the X3 because the receiver doesn't interfere with the stitch line at all. One thing you will see here is the DJI Mic 2, which acts as a Bluetooth wireless microphone. And I put this here just to say that for the current firmware I have, which I'll put on the screen below, this doesn't work. This used to work. And then the most recent firmware, it just doesn't work. And it works off the same connection mechanism as you would use for AirPods. So you connect this in the same way as you do for AirPods. Unfortunately, while it does connect and while the Ace Pro does recognize the DJI Mic 2, it doesn't record any audio. Hopefully that's going to be addressed in firmware updates. So let's get to it and let's go outside and do some testing. So this is the first test of the audio options for the Insta360 Ace Pro. As you can see, I'm holding this about maybe a hand's distance from my mouth. It is quite windy today. So I'm going to start again because I did have the camera, the Ace Pro, on wind direction or wind reduction even, and I've now switched it to stereo because I'm moving into an area where there's not so much wind. It's much more enclosed here, so it's better. I don't really need to have wind reduction on. I've got stereo on. So I'm holding it about an arm's length from my mouth, trying to keep things level, but I'm terrible at keeping the camera level. So this is the Ace Pro's internal audio, internal microphones only, nothing else. Now we're getting a bit of wind, it's picked up again. But this is going to act as the baseline for the other comparisons. So the second option today is using AirPods. Now these aren't the original Apple AirPods, first generation, they're not the AirPods Pro or anything. But I'm using AirPods now, and unlike the X3, where I tried to connect AirPods, this actually works on the Ace Pro. You can actually, and quite easily, connect your AirPods, which is really quite useful. They can be quite a good source of audio. And yeah, if you're in a pinch, you can use your AirPods if you want sort of a wireless microphone system or you don't have anything. It is windy and these are going to be really prone to wind noise, unfortunately. And it connects really easily, whereas with the X3, it's so hit and miss that inevitably you give up rather than ever get the AirPods connected. So this is with the AirPods on the Insta360 Ace Pro. So my next option is using the audio adapter. So I'm now using the audio adapter and I'm using just a standard lavalier microphone. Maybe this isn't standard because this is actually a TRRS microphone. It's designed to plug into smartphones. So I've got it running through an adapter which goes from TRRS to TRS. But yeah, it's plugged into the Ace Pro audio adapter, and this is a much better fit, this Ace Pro audio adapter, than the one you get on the X3. It snaps into place, it feels like it's not going to fall off, and generally it's just, I feel it's much better than the one I've been using for the X3. Of course, the one you use for the X3 won't work. USB-C microphones and receivers won't work with this. You have to get the audio adapter. So is this any good? Is this better? I'm holding this really close to my mouth, holding it very close to my mouth, really to get the best audio quality. And again, it is windy. I don't have a wind muff for this. All I've got is a plosive filter, which is just the foam that goes around the microphone. And so now the final one in my test today is the Movo wireless mic set. And this is personally my favorite for the Insta360 because it doesn't have any problems with the stitch line. And this is personally my favorite with the Insta360 X3 because it neatly fits into the stitch line and you don't get any stitch line problems. There's no cables to worry about because, as you can see, it just plugs into the audio jack. One of the things I don't like about this is there's no wind muff whatsoever. I put on the, you can see there, I just showed you that I put on the plosive filter, but it's not very good, and so this microphone setup is prone to wind. We're in an enclosed area, but over there you can see there's a road, so maybe it evens out in terms of a good environment to record in or a good way to test things out. So this is the Movo wireless mic set. The set I have works for the Insta360 X3 really well, and you've got two microphones on this set, so this is a good set, but I don't know what it's going to sound like on the Ace Pro, if it's going to be any good at all. So let's talk conclusions. Using the internal microphones on the X3 was okay, and it's better to use the stereo focus than the wind reduction. Obviously, you may find yourself needing to use wind reduction, as I did when I went out to do the test. AirPods give less background noise, but it does sound incredibly tinny. So I would only use these if I'm in a pinch and I'm in a really noisy place, because it does reduce background noise, but I'm not sure it's worth it for the loss in quality. So the best one really was using the wired lapel microphone or the wireless microphone system. Using a wired lavalier microphone is going to be a lot cheaper. This was only around £12 or $12, but using the wireless set is going to give you a lot more versatility and freedom. You can move away from your camera, and while that's something I don't generally do, I tend to be holding the camera all the time, using a wireless set does give you ability to move away from your camera. It gives you the ability to have two inputs or two people talking at the same time, and you can do that in sets where you've got two transmitters. So personally, my favorite is always going to be the wireless option, and this is a good wireless set, and you can check this out in the description below. You can get maybe cheaper using a wired lavalier microphone, but because you're ultimately going to be running this through an adapter and Insta360 are never great with their audio, I don't think you need to spend a lot of money or use a really expensive lav microphone. I'm not sure you're going to hear the difference between a cheaper lavalier microphone, a wireless microphone, or an expensive wired lavalier microphone, but those are just my thoughts.